Welcome, fellow scientists. Bee here. Today we're going to take a trip back in time to explore why science is so important. Longevity. What does that word mean to you? The length of one's life? Or perhaps you agree with Webster's dictionary and view longevity as having a longer than normal life. Globally, the human lifespan has dramatically increased for decades, meaning we now live longer than we did hundreds of years ago. But why? I mean, it can't be genetic, right? After all, our ancestors had the same genes we have today, so if it's not genetics, then what is it? To answer this question, we'll have to go back in time to when kings and queens ruled supreme, and unhygienic living conditions, as well as little access to effective medical care, limited life expectancy to about 35 years. Sounds scary. Stick around if you dare, because in today's lesson, we'll identify why science is important and explore scientific progress through the lens of a health-related disaster. These maps show the global history of life expectancy over the last two centuries. Let's look at the first map together. Yikes! That's a lot of red. According to the key, the color red tells us that at the beginning of the 19th century, no country had a life expectancy longer than 40 years. That's because at that time, almost everyone in the world, apart from nobility, lived in extreme poverty, had little medical knowledge, and was undoubtedly prepared for an early death. We see a very different picture when we shift our focus to the next map, which gives us a snapshot of how life expectancy changed from the years 1800 to 1950. Feel free to pause the video, take a closer look at the map, and record your observations in the guided notes. Then, when you're ready, resume the video. As always, I'll be here waiting on you. Welcome back! So, fellow science sleuths, what did you observe? Well done! We see an increase in life expectancy. However, quite sadly, not everyone experienced the same increase. During these 150 years, some parts of the world achieved significant health advancements, while others did not. This gave way to a huge global imbalance. For example, citizens of Iceland had a life expectancy of 81 years, while the people of Mali were only expected to live for about 26 years. That's a difference of 55 years! Let's hop over to the final map and look at the changes since 1950. Because the world has made rapid progress in health, most people today can expect to live as long as those in the healthiest countries in 1950, with a life expectancy of 72.6 years. Globally, the life expectancy has increased from less than 30 years to over 72 years, and after two centuries of progress, we can expect to live much more than twice as long as our ancestors. Knowing what you know now, riddle me this. Why do you think people can expect to live more than twice as long today? I mean, what changed? I'll tell you. The most significant change is science, specifically the scientific method, which we covered in the last lesson. The scientific method is the system used by scientists to explore data, generate and test hypotheses, develop new theories, and confirm or reject earlier results. Although the exact methods used in the different sciences vary, for example, meteorologists who study the weather and paleontologists who study fossil records work in very different ways, they share the core principles of scientific inquiry. The most notable being that scientific knowledge builds a body of knowledge that is always growing and changing as scientists ask new questions and rethink what was known before. What do you say we jump into our Miacademy time machine and explore what our world looked like before and after the scientific revolution? Well, what are you waiting for? Buckle up and prepare for takeoff, because we're out of here! Close your eyes as we travel back in time to Europe. The year is 1347. We see 12 ships arriving from the Black Sea and docking at the Sicilian port of Messina. And because we're from the future and have the inside scoop, we know that these ships carry a terrible and mysterious plague. Let's rocket forward a few years to the year 1350. Oh no! The mysterious plague has ravaged Europe and Asia and has already claimed millions of lives. We see people trying everything they can to avoid catching the mystery plague. They're carrying flowers, burning incense, firing cannons, and ringing church bells. Whole families are even barricading themselves in their homes to keep the disease from spreading. But nothing is helping. Sadly, the death rate continues to soar. I think we've had enough tragedy for one day. Let's end this mission and travel back to the present day. Hold on to your hat, and we're back! Wow, that was really tough to see. Today, we know that the terrible mystery disease that devastated Europe and Asia was the bubonic plague, also known as the Black Death, a serious bacterial infection transmitted through fleas that live on mice, rats, and other rodents. Fortunately, due to scientific advancements, if someone catches the sickness today, they can be treated with antibiotics and expect to be healthy again after a couple of weeks. However, before scientists made these discoveries, people, including plague doctors like the ones seen here, didn't know what was causing the severe sickness and didn't have a cure. As a result, countless lives were lost to the bubonic plague. In the 14th century, 2/3 of Europe's population died from this sickness alone. The inability of 14th century medicine to stop the plague from devastating societies throughout Europe and Asia challenged scientists of that time to re-examine their method of scientific inquiry. How did people get this disease? Why did some people survive and so many die? Why did their treatments fail? The bubonic plague led doctors to pay closer attention to what they could learn directly from bodies, the environmental factors contributing to disease, and what they learned from books. But first, they had to survive this awful disease. There's no doubt that progress in science and technology has transformed the world and our relationship with it. But we still face huge challenges: cancer, climate change, and the extinction of plants and animals, to name a few. But they are not insurmountable. Together, we can make discoveries that will further our knowledge and improve our lives in ways we can't imagine. Just like those in the 14th century couldn't have imagined how easy it would be for us to treat the bubonic plague today. Hey, don't forget to check out the engaging games and thought-provoking resources related to this lesson to prepare for our next lesson, where we'll explore science in action. And remember, you are out of this world. See you next time. Hey, hey.